Hi, I'm Joni Patry, and welcome to my YouTube channel. Well, today I want to talk about a lot of things I've been predicting for a while. And you got to know you were getting pretty frustrated with me every time I said secrets are being revealed. Well, they were. Drips and drips, little by little, and now I think most people know the secret's out. So what do I always say? I always say the eclipses bring out something we didn't know. And a lot of you are going to say, oh, but I already knew that. But really, only a few people knew this because it's so god-awful that people didn't want to believe it. But now there is proof because, like I say, follow the money. And what am I talking about? What am I talking about that's just really come out? Yes, what I want to talk about today, I probably shouldn't, but I am George Soros, because so many people on my Patreon page have been asking me over and over to do a YouTube on George Soros. I was always afraid to, because I mean, these are the elites that control the world. And it's finally come out that not only was George Soros behind a lot of the funding for all of these protests, going way back to 2020, all of the riots, the protests, everything that has been happening where there is so much violence and commotion, it's been all funded by the elites and elite companies. Okay, before I get into this deep, I want to remind everyone of a few wonderful things that you can do. You can sign up for my free newsletter. Go to galacticcenter.org. Get my predictions delivered free to your email address every week. Plus, while you're there, check out my Patreon page. That is where we come together in a community where we do discuss things that we feel like we can't discuss here. Yes, this is going to be two classes live with me a week. Go to Patreon, and don't forget, I'm starting soon my Galactic Planner. And that is where you're going to get all your personal predictions delivered to your calendar every day. So what do? Go to galacticplanner.com, sign up for a free month. See if you like it. It's free. And there you can get on the list where you will be given the Galactic Planner. We're all going to try it out. I think you're going to love it. If you have not been able to get a reading, this is going to do it for you. So check it out, galacticplanner.com. Let me get going with what I'm talking about. I've been telling you the truth is being exposed for so many years. All this ugliness has been going on. And now we're pretty much seeing what it's all about. And here's the really awful part that I want you to know. And I've gotten this right off of the internet. And what I'm talking about is Wikipedia. This is not, I'm not making this up. George Soros, a Hungarian-born American billionaire, hedge fund manager and philanthropist. As of October of 2023, he has a net worth of only $6.7 billion because he donated $32 billion to the Open Society Foundations, of which $15 billion has already been distributed, representing 64% of his original fortune. This is Wikipedia. And let me just say, here is another thing that is pretty disgusting, that they claim these donations are to charities. So guess what? It's nonprofit. Guess what? They get a tax write-off. The government's paying for all this. Does that make you kind of nauseous? Well, it does me. So I want you to know, I pulled up George Soros's chart. Now, of course, we don't have his birth time. You know, that's going to be pretty hard to come by. But You know, you can do a lot with astrology by just looking at where all the planets are on that day, because we are able to see when transits will hit their planets, regardless if we know what house they're in. The planet means something. So, for example, the sun is the physical being, Mars is our willpower. All the planets are indicators of something. So when I pull up a chart like this, and of course, looking in the middle of the day, the moon changes signs. So normally I make the moon the ascendant, but I don't know if this moon is in Aquarius or if it's in Pisces, but it's in one of the two. But I do know that his sun sits in Cancer. Let me put up the chart I have. So we have his birthday, which is August 12th, 1930. Yes, he is 93 years old, going on 94. Wow. You know, a lot of these elites get access to a lot of health-giving things that can keep them alive longer. Let me just say that. But yes, so the other thing is, it has been said that his son, Alexander, he's passing over a lot of his work to him. So I pulled up his chart to see as well if there was anything I could find. And of course, I don't have his birth time either, but we can see where all his planets are. So let's put up Alexander Soros as well, beneath George Soros' chart. Now, Alexander was born October 27th, 1985. And I just do noon just to see middle of the day so we could see where the planets are. See if we can see something coming up. And one thing for sure is that George Soros is in Sati Sati. What is Sati Sati? It's when Saturn comes to the moon. The sign before, the sign of, and the sign after the moon. That's actually a seven-year cycle. But we know his moon is somewhere in Aquarius and Pisces. So Saturn's coming to the moon. This is heavy. This is difficult. I gotta say, this is not an easy time for him, because the moon is how you feel. So the fact that all of his workings and doings are being exposed is not what he wants. He's been working undercover for a long time with all of the protests that have been going on. I don't even need to say them all, but you know, from 2020 onward to now, and maybe even things prior to that. And of course, I'm not even naming all the other organizations that they claim are working together with Soros to bring down the United States. I don't know why they want to do this, but obviously they do. And, you know, disempowering the police all that time, that really weakened the structure of the United States. So think what you want, but this is what's been happening. Okay, so let's look at George Soros' chart. So looking at his chart, I noticed he's in Sati Sati, and you know, Saturn's going to go into Pisces next springtime, so in 2025. So it's covering the portion of Aquarius and Pisces. And I get for 12 noon that the moon, his moon, is around 28 degrees of Aquarius, and Saturn is right around there throughout 2024 to 2025. So he's got a lot of problems. Now, here's something that's going to uplift him. So in other words, he's going to be happy with the end result of when in September. Yes, so he's got some big action planned, I believe, for us in September, because transiting Jupiter will conjunct his natal Mars. We know his Mars is at 26 degrees of Taurus, and Jupiter is going to be back and forth at Mars, which means Mars is action, willpower, drive, ambition, what's going on. Transiting Jupiter hitting his Mars means he feels successful with what he's doing. So there's a good result happening throughout the whole time for him that Jupiter is in Taurus, which had just entered May 1st. But I get September is a good time, as well as well into 2025. Now, the end of May and June of 2025, this looks pretty difficult for him because I'm looking at his sun at 26 degrees of Cancer. And yes, transiting Mars is going to go retrograde in Cancer. And that's going to be right around when I see the biggest biggest havoc going on in the U.S. And that will be right after the elections. So they're going to add probably fuel to the fire of what's happening in December of 2024. But Mars will be stationing in Cancer, not exactly on his sun, but it's in the same sign as his sun at 26 degrees of Cancer. But come around the time of May and June of 2025, Mars will cross over the sun in Cancer. Here's the deal. Mars is going to pretty much go back and forth between, well, for a long time, the signs of Gemini and Cancer. So it's going to be October, probably starting in August, October, November, then December through January, it will be in Cancer. Then it's going to be in Gemini again in February of 2025. And this all propels George Soros's chart because Mars will be going over his natal Jupiter in Gemini. And then it's going to finally come to May and June. It will conjunct. And let me double check that. May and June, Mars will be 26 degrees of Cancer. And I am looking at this date being, yep, that's correct. The end of May and June of 2025. So consider this, he's got propulsion, energy, things are going the way he planned. But I think as Saturn starts to go over the moon, he's going to start losing his power. One thing I will say, remember I said Jupiter will conjunct his Mars September of 2024. Then come right before that, August 22nd, Mars will conjunct his Mars. He's going to be full power ahead. Things are happening. Lots of fire he's going to be putting out there. Lots and lots. And really, I think May is a time we have to be careful of. Now let's go down and look to Alexander Soros's planets. We don't necessarily have his chart, but where his planets are. And one thing that I think is really significant, now we don't know where his moon is, because at 12 noon, the moon is about to change signs from Gemini to Aries. So his moon is either in Pisces or Aries. His moon is in Pisces. So his natal moon is definitely either in the sign of Pisces or in the sign of Aries. But let me just say this, where Rahu and Ketu are transiting, Rahu is in Pisces and Saturn's going to be in Pisces. So Saturn's coming up and will eventually catch up with his moon. So there's going to be a downfall for both he and his father while Saturn is in Pisces. But that is going to be beginning around the end of March of 2025 for 2 years following. Saturn will be in Pisces. But let me give you a timeline that's very specific. While Saturn goes into Pisces around the end of March, Rahu will still be in Pisces till around the end of May. So I'm going to say the end of March to the end of May of 2025, we're going to have Rahu and Saturn conjunct. They're going to cross over each other. Something big is going to happen. And this could be something big that is not so much in the favor of the Soros family because of where their moon sits. Both of them have a moon in around the same sector of, well, George Soros is Aquarius Pisces, but Alexander is Pisces Aries. So Saturn's coming to that position. But let's go a little bit further. Let's go a little bit further, because here is something for him to look out for. And that's going to be around December and January again, because then transiting K2 will cross over his natal Mars. This is in Alexander's chart. So Mars is the will, it's the desire, it's aggression, it's energy. So K2 going over Mars means the energy will be weakened in some way. So looking at both charts, I think the biggest events that are coming and that maybe they're funding or being a part of are going to happen between, well, I'm going to say October through January, but to define it down to the most intense, it's going to be December and January. December 2024 and January 2025. And here's what I hope will happen. That the cat will be out of the bag. We'll know what's going on. And therefore, if we see what's been going on, then we know what to do to remedy it. So the truth will come out. The truth has been coming out. And I've been talking about it for so long. Another thing to look out for is that the eclipse in October will reveal more of what I've been talking about. Remember what I say about eclipses, and this is a fact. It is the darkening of the light. And in that darkness, things we didn't know about will be revealed. And that is what's happening throughout all these eclipse patterns that we've been seeing, especially this major eclipse that happened April 8th, said, look out for what's going to be revealed. And now it's revealed, but it hasn't really sunk in, I think, to most people, because who wants to believe that? I don't. But only when we accept the truth can we move on to heal it. Because what I always say is this, that we are in a position where the truth is coming out. This is a major awakening, a transformational change. And guess what? From this, there will be a great healing. And from this, we're going to see exactly what needs to be done to make this a better world for the future and future generations, to be based on the goodness of the world, the goodness to heal the world and make it a more beautiful place to live for all of us. So that's my intention, that's my wish with this. But I just want you to see what's been being revealed. It's no secret now. It's out. Do the research. See what I'm talking about. I got this information off of Wikipedia, and it's all out there. And yeah, it's become very obvious now. There's no more denying it. So thank you for listening. Remember, if you want more information about me, you can always go to my website, galacticcenter.org. Sign up for my free newsletter. Become part of my Patreon page. Get exclusive information nowhere else but my Patreon page. And don't forget about my Galactic Planner. So that's galacticplanner.com. Thank you.